to swim in the open sky, to achieve the tenderness of the clouds, to suspend these masses in the distance very far away, gray mist, and then make the blue explode. I feel all of this coming, dawning in my intentions. What joy and what torment! If the bottom were still, perhaps I would never reach these depths. Did they do better in the past? Did the Dutch achieve the poetry of the clouds I seek? Eugene Boudin. Eugene Boudin was born in 1824 in Honfleur, France. He was one of the first French landscape painters ever to paint outdoors. A marine painter, essentially, Boudin worked as a boy on the steamboats that ran to Le Havre and later ran a picture frame shop that brought works by Jean-Francois Millet and Jean-Baptiste Isabey into his hands. At a mere 22, he eluded commerce for painting, later becoming an absorptive student of Isabey and a copyist at the Louvre. By 1857, Boudin had befriended a wildly talented 18-year-old who'd been gleaning his living drawing caricatures and convinced him to try painting out under the skies. That 18-year-old was named Claude Monet. Light is the most important person in the picture, Claude Monet. Oscar Claude Monet was born in Paris in 1840, the son of a singer who encouraged his art before dying when Monet was a mere 16. At the Louvre, his youthful studies were defiant, famously foregoing copying those great masters that his peers were, and drawing from his view at the museum's window ledges. With Boudin's bolstering, his emotive eyes and hands dashed and dabbed wind and sunlight into burgeoning new art forms. Along with his contemporaries, Alfred Sisley and Camille Pissarro, Monet absorbed a confluence of controversy and a creative spark when exhibiting his Impression Sunrise, converting critics' disparaging comments into a new generation of light-filled genius. For an Impressionist to paint from nature is not to paint the subject, but to realize the sensations, Paul Cézanne. Paul Cézanne, born in 1839 in Aix-Provence, France, yoked his studies at the Louvre with a kinship and deep impressions from his older friend Camille Pissarro. Their collaborative excursions pulled his work, which were initially culled from imagination, towards the determinate, direct observation of nature. His visual discipline and distinctive planar marks created the scaffolding for a bridge from Impressionism to Cubism and from one painted century to the next. Art to me is the interpretation of an impression which nature makes upon the eye and brain. Child Hassan. Born in 1859 in Dorchester, Massachusetts, as the son of an antique collector, Child Hassan was artistically weaned in a draftsmanship shop, engraving. He sought an education at Lowell Institute and later in Europe, where he hungrily consumed the masterful watercolors that he discovered by J.M.W. Turner and fortified his senses with the works of Monet, Pissarro, Corot, and his other European contemporaries. Hassan brought Impressionism to the American shores with the prolific courting of an intimate and elegant New England lifestyle, dappled in the splendor of extended sunlight.